Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 4 in our series, statelesscode.com WordPress. So in the previous video, I installed some test data and kind of used Composer to get Sage into this Stateless Sage directory. And so now I'm going to try to see if I can get this like an initial commit, push it to GitHub, and get going on that, and also see if I can get a symbolic link working where the themes directory of WordPress will point to this Stateless Sage directory. So let me first see if I can npm install. Sure, I'm doing that correctly. It might be yarn. So it looks like it might be using npm for. For this and. So I think we've installed successfully. Do we have a .gitignore file for this? We do have a gitignore file. Okay, node modules vendor public debug log error log. Okay. Let's see if we can do a git init here. Got our item here. Let me take a look at our items here. Add gitignore first. And then see if we can do a git add dot. And get our initial commit going. So git commit sign. Write my commit message. All right, so I've got my commit message. I'll sign it. All right, and so this repo does not yet exist, so I need to go into stateless code, create a new repo. All right, so I've got my repository ready to create. Hit the button. Take the value from this. that looks like it worked. We've got our, I'll have to fix the repo information, but the other thing that I'm going to do here is create a project so that we have a backlog to work from. Oh, click on projects, click on create a project. I'm just going to call this one. All right, so I've got the project board name, basic Kanban. All right, just get rid of these items here. All right, so I'll start and populate. Just add got a column, why is it not showing? All right, I'll just populate with some issues and then we'll see what happens. All right, so I've got a basic list of to-dos. Actually, I'm gonna add a couple more. So I just added in, adding it, making sure I've got a minimum viable home page and about page on the real statelesscode.com before I launch it. Let's get the, see if we can get the symlink situation working. So I'm going to go in and become the root user for a moment here. And let's go to actually, I might be able to just do, well, all right, so we can see here there's a 2019 directory, a 2020 directory, and a 2021 directory. So let's see if we can do a symbolic link here. Okay, so that is root here. And then everything else is stateless code. So I think I can get this to the same user. not working. Let me see if I can. All right, so let's make sure I didn't go in and. So I'm supposed to use the dash age. Let me. Yeah, I changed the original. So let's change that back to stateless code. So that's back to where it's supposed to be. And then I need to do so it didn't seem to work recursively, but group. So what I'll do is I'll go into so that's given me, I think, what I want. So that might work. Let's see if we can. Now in our actual local site, let's go back to appearance. Let's see if we can activate this. There we go. So we've got the theme in place. We'll take a look at the options there. So let me see what I've got in. We can now look at the see what the nested and mixed lists look like, all this other stuff. So It's not that pretty yet, but at least it's not. Hideous green. So we'll now go in and see what happens. Let's say if I, so these are the, this is the directory here now. If we go to style, so we've got our theme name here, URI and all that stuff will wind up changing, but let me at least see if I can get the get something to change here and see if it propagates. So take a look at my config. Just going to temporarily go into resources, styles, editor. So it looks like it's just by default. Getting the Tailwind CSS stuff that we've got. All right, let's see if the 404 item here. So, sorry, but the page you're trying to view does not exist. Let's see if I can change this to and taxation is theft and see what happens on the local. So that got updated. So I think we're in sync with each other. The that will be good enough for now, and I'll get going on trying to get some basic styling in place for this. I will move my symlink item to done if I can figure out how to show done. Okay, so I went back to the project and then back into it, and now the done column is showing up. So I didn't actually do anything, but that worked for now. Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.